If I ever said I'm never scared, just know I mean it. If I ever said I fuck your bitch, just know I mean it. And if I ever said I'm getting money, just know I mean it. And oh Lord knows, he knows I mean it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, boys and girls. Hello, and welcome to another episode of the I Mean It podcast. Here with your boy, Bocephus, on the Revolution Network. Hope you guys out there are enjoying the ad we have going. It's doing pretty well for us, so been pretty happy on that. We have never done anything like that before, so was kind of a little bit apprehensive about it, but it turned out well. So I would suggest that to any fellow podcasters out there. And remember, like the ad said, if you want to be a podcaster, please hit us up at info@therevolutionnetwork on gmail.com. You can email us there and find out the details on joining the Revolution Network and all the benefits that brings to you, whether it's free advertising, free publishing, free hosting, all the stuff that we provide. As long as you don't suck. that's pretty much our only requirement. Anyway, so this week, I don't really have a whole lot. I was thinking about something earlier. And it's something that, you know, you only start to realize as you get older, as a dude. I'll say as a dude. I don't know about chicks. But as a dude, you know, as you get older, you start to realize that, and I remember hearing this when I was younger, and I was like, fucking crazy, but, you know, sometimes you just kind of prefer to jack off than to have sex, right? Now, for any younger guys listening to the show or watching the show, look, I know what you're thinking, right? That's mind-blowing to you. You're like, you're fucking crazy. And it is mind-blowing, you know. It's kind of like when you were a kid and Halloween would come around. Now, again, if you're my age or of my generation, back in the day, boys and girls, you would have some people in the neighborhood that wouldn't, you know, do the store-bought, you know, assortment of candy. They would actually homemake an assortment of candy. So saying that you would rather masturbate than have sex is like when you were a kid saying you'd rather get that homemade bundle of candy rather than the store-bought, professionally put-together assortment. Oh, man, do you remember the fucking homemade bundle of candy? Holy shit, how bad was that? I mean, you had the fucking gum from like the Mesozoic fucking era. That's how fucking dry that shit was. It wasn't even like double bubble. It was single bubble. You know, because double bubble hadn't even been fucking invented yet. They didn't know. The gum scientists were not aware that you could double the bubble. As of the time that gum was made, the pharaohs chewed that gum. Oh, so you had that shit. And of course you had your mainstays. You know, all your hard candies. Your butterscotch. The weird one that was wrapped in the red foil. I don't even know what the fuck that was. I never even opened one of them. I wasn't ever that big on candy anyway as a kid. So mystery candy definitely didn't, you know, tickle my fucking fancy. So let me know if anybody out there remembers that red foil and what was in that fucking thing, because I just wasn't going to take the time to open it. And of course you had the fucking peppermints, right? That's the fucking mainstay. You know, but sometimes though, you would get the peppermint, but then you'd also get another thing that looked like a peppermint, but instead of the red stripes, it would have green stripes. What the fuck was that? I mean, you had to put like another type of mint with the peppermint. Like one fucking kind of mint is not enough. You need spearmint or wintergreen or whatever the fuck that green shit is that they put on peppermints. And you got rid of the red, which I don't even know what part of the peppermint the red serves. Is that the pepper? Is it the mint? I don't know. I'm not like a fucking hard candy mixologist. I have no idea how that shit is made, but you took a pretty prominent piece of the peppermint away and then put a green stripe in its place and somehow made it more minty. Like that, like you even fuck, like you, like anybody was sitting around thinking, eating a peppermint and going, you know what this fucking needs? More mint. Need more mint. Oh my God. I don't know who the fuck that was for. Who invented that? I have no idea. That's banana sandwich to me. That you needed more mint with a fucking peppermint. Oh. But yeah, we had homemade bundles of candy. Or store-bought, you know, assortments. So, what I'm trying to say is, I don't think now, see, you still wouldn't want to take the homemade bundle of candy. Like, so I guess that analogy doesn't work out. But I guess what I'm trying to say, the analogy was, it's just as insane to young people when you say something like, well, I'd rather masturbate sometimes than have sex. It's just as nuts. Because like when you're growing up, you know, just the candy thing, you want candy. Well, when you're growing up as a boy, like, that's all you get to do is masturbate, right? You're trying to work up to the sex thing is all you ever hear about. It's all you think about. That's like, you know, you get to go to fucking Willy Wonka factory and like, nah, you know, I'd rather fucking stay home. Like, what? Like, no fucking, you know, adolescent boy or even young man could comprehend what I'm trying to say right now. All I'm telling you is there'll come a time where maybe you'll think back to this podcast. I'm like, you know what? That guy was fucking right. Or maybe you'll just see one of those weird-ass green striped peppermints and go, that's what the fuck he's talking about. I don't know. I don't even know if they make that shit anymore. I don't think they make the red wrapped candy anymore at all. I don't. That's probably illegal at this point, or it should be. I don't even know what was in it. It doesn't matter. Can't just fucking wrap candy in anonymous fucking wrappers with no window into said candy and hand that out to children. That's how, you know, all those fucking crazy rumors got started, that people were drugging kids and don't take candy from strangers, is because you fucking tried to disguise your candy there, fucking pedo Pete. The red wrap candy is definitely handed out of the Biden household. They don't even wait for Halloween. It could be a fucking Tuesday. Those fucking freaks. Oh, I guess that's about it for that. So I don't really have a good way to summarize what I just said. So I'll just leave it at that. You can decipher it as you will. On the football front, I'm doing a lot of data mining right now. I just stopped actually doing some to record this podcast and put something out for you guys. So you'd have something to listen to and numb your mind as you're doing probably mind-numbing work already at work or school or wherever the fuck you're listening to this shit. Anywhere, anytime, I really appreciate it. We really appreciate it. Please continue to grow the network, The Revolution Network. Subscribe, subscribe, subscribe. Get every podcast, this podcast, The Bastards of Babylon, Football and Freedom, and, of course, The Football Glory Hole, which will be coming back very soon with some draft stuff and chronicling our trip all the way to Kansas City. We'll see if we make it back. We'll see. You never fucking know. All right, boys and girls, that's all I got for you this week. Until next time, I'll be thinking about you. If I ever said I'm never-